There's going to be a video showing my GEC746 clone. This is a clone from the GPO model. I don't have a 746F, but I do have a 746L, but similar to that phone. But this is a GPO one. The main difference you'll see on the base, and I'll show you the underside, it won't say GPO. Way to tell a clone of a 746, it would have a copy of Ericsson or GEC here. On the back, copy say ATL, Ericsson Telephone Limited, or like mine says GEC on the back. I think AD's Shed had one of these, but his one had a figure only bezel like the N1900s have. And on the bottom, this one says 746 Gen 72-1, and then GEC made in England. It has similar stuff to the GPO, so one of these was a, it is a clone. I'm not sure if it was a splice of the GPO, because you look underneath a normal 746. There's a similar marking, but this one's not a bit different. But this is a GEC one. There is two types of GEC 746s in the world. There's a GPO one, there's the British one, and there's the New Zealand Post Office version. But the New Zealand goes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This way round. This one goes down clockwise. England one. I'll demonstrate it. But the funny thing is, none of this is the clones don't have induction coils on the 746 circuit board in this one. I took it apart. It doesn't have an induction coil. Any of those light bulbs will draw a bit of voltage down. There's a dialing tone. And again, through the terminal, transmitter. Now, some silly fool put this into the phone in the wrong place. And what they did, I took this out of the phone because this was on linking T10 and T1. And it was shorting out the microphone, so I take that out to make it work. But now I'll demonstrate the ring. Quite a good ring this is. Now that's my new GEC 746 made in 1972 with a Mark 1 case. Now this is a GPO, GEC 746. I'm actually going to put a GPO label on there and preserve that label because I don't want to ruin that label. Because I can't use my photocopy now because the glass shed on my phone, because I'll get a new photocopier before I do that. But normally what I would do, I would copy the label on my printer and make a copy of it and then keep the original one in a plastic bag of other labels and put a fake in there. So if I want to use the right one, I could write on it. The reason why I'm demonstrating this in here is because I've got a PBX involved up there. But that's my new GEC 746 made in 1972 as a Mark 1.